Clyde DeWeather, showing us why after 40 MMA fights, he's the champ. He's able to weather these storms, but this fight almost stopped, in my opinion.
Well, there's Jadamba, his face looking quite clear. No marks there other than a little swelling on the forehead, but look at Oishi, that left eye is closing. And while Jason was taking you through the replays, I was having a look and they were working quite furiously to try and get that swelling down with the ice. And remember, this being a five-round fight, 15 minutes still to go. There's a lot of scope for that left eye of the Japanese fighter to close further. And as an orthodox fighter leading with his left hand, that means his vision will be severely compromised.
Your vision is compromised, and also your depth perception, because, you know, obviously everyone sees in three dimensions, and when you have one eye swollen shut, you can only see half as much, but also your timing and your accuracy just go out the window because you can't see and you can't gauge as well. You know, there's a certain amount of instinct that you rely on, but when you're a fighter and you see your opponent's wounded, I think Jadamba is going to start going at this. I mean, Rich, how do you see this up and through the first 10 minutes here?
I think Jadamba is really increasing his lead here, but Oishi started mounting some offense in that round. Inflicted some damage. You can see it on the forehead of Jadamba, but clearly Jadamba has this fight with the takedowns and the striking superiority on the ground.
If you were in Oishi's corner, what would you tell him at this point?
Well, he's got to start really mounting up an offense on his feet here. He's swinging one at a time, and he needs to start putting combinations together. Bunches and bunches, basically. He's not effectively timing Jadamba on the counter at this point.
Yeah, I agree. And Jadamba's really putting together a bunch of combinations, and that's paid off because sometimes it's not that first punch or second punch, it's that third or fourth one that get through. And Oishi's going to have a very difficult time just throwing a haymaker like that from far out.
And as we approach the halfway mark of this fight, I would suggest that Koji Oishi's featherweight championship belt is in danger of being put round his opponent's waist. A long way to go in this fight, but Oishi has work to do, and there's blood on his nose now, trickling perhaps from the eyebrow. That eye causing him severe problem.
Nice head kick. And Oishi able to turn that into a single leg takedown. And Jadamba right back up to his feet. Good work. Well, you see, Jadamba's game plan is to stay off of his back and just keep the fight exactly where it's going. Didn't waste any time playing with guard. And Oishi didn't push into Jadamba either when he was on the ground. You notice that he disengaged and let Jadamba up. So I wonder if Oishi thinks that maybe I can open up here at some point.
That cut looks to be just a little nick between the eyebrows. Nothing too significant at this stage. The swelling, I would venture, is causing him far more problems. Jason mentioned depth perception. That means that you have difficulty judging your opponent's punchings coming in, and of course the punches that you throw in terms of being able to land them. It's all about timing when you're only looking out of one eye.
Jadamba's doing a good job of throwing multiple punches together. I'd like to see him follow up some of those punches with a kick. He knows that Oishi keeps circling to his lead hand. He could just throw a 1-2 and then start attacking that leg and give Oishi some other things to think about, because Jadamba's thrown two head kicks. I think both of them got caught so far. It's just such a lot of distance. It's such a tremendous amount of distance to travel from your foot being on the ground all the way up to the head if you don't set it up with anything.
Oh, good right hand from Jadamba.
Great right hand.
And it landed on that eye. Wouldn't you just believe it?
It looks like a lot's landed on that eye, and I think Jadamba's smart to keep attacking that side. And Oishi really needs to figure out how he can unravel this situation, because as the minutes and seconds tick by,
Oh, a good right hand. This is what we saw against Panario. He can just pull them out of the bag, and they can be big differences in big fights.
It looks like Jadamba's a little bit covered. Oishi's gonna want to keep the pressure on here.
He needs this.
Yeah, that was as close to having Jadamba clocked as he did in this whole fight. He kind of let the pressure off. You see the confidence is building, and Jadamba's getting a little more timid. See, he just pulled back that knee. I don't think Jadamba's fully recovered, and Oishi's giving him what he needs right now is that minute rest.
Left hand from Jadamba follows it up with a right to the body.
But if there's one thing that we've seen from Koji Uishi, it's that at any point he's capable of finishing a fight. Did it twice in the Benario. Two knockouts that were back.
Oh, great kick.
That was a beautiful spinning axe kick.
And right on that eye.
Kick, I'm sorry.
By the time he comes out for the fourth round, if indeed he does, I don't think he's going to be seeing anything out of that left eye, the Japanese. Wouldn't surprise me if the doctors take a look at it. Final 10 seconds of the third round. And Narotongolog Jodamba is mounting what could be the shock of the night. He was never a huge underdog, but many would have fancied Uishi.
Well, we're going into the championship rounds now. This fight would be over for all intents and purposes. And here we see Uishi had that window of opportunity that was just fleeting. You see Jodamba here, it looked like he wasn't super composed. Hands are down, he's kind of wobbling a little bit on his legs. And Koji wasn't able to capitalize on it, but that was the most offense we saw him get going.
Oh, wow.
And then Jodamba with the crazy spinning back kick caught the hand of Uishi a little bit, took some of the brunt off, but still will ring your bell.
One or two welts then on the forehead of the Mongolian. But that's where the real damage has been done. And I think you could see there the little nick there on the inside, the left-hand side of the upper nose area of Uishi. Nothing too significant.
You know, and speaking of damage, there's two types of damage that the judges look for. One is the obvious physical damage, swollen eyes, cuts, broken noses, things like that. The second one is internal damage. When you drop a guy with a body shot or you had him rocked and he was all over the place and he had rubber legs, you know, that taking the wind out. So obviously, the majority of that is going to be seen easy. But having it to judge one of these is a tough, tough nut to crack. Rich, how do you see this so far?
Again, I think Jodamba's just increasing his lead a little bit more. You look at the damage inflicted by both of these guys. Uishi inflicted some damage there, but he caught Jodamba with a great combination in that round. But then Jodamba turned around and hit him with a good spinning heel kick. And if you look at the striking superiority just as this fight develops from Jodamba, he's running away with it.
Well, there you have it. So far, I think everyone here at the comms booth would agree that Jodamba's up. Jodamba just had a nice takedown again on Uishi. Didn't really finish it up all the way, but definitely staying more active. What a nice knee.
If this then was a three-round contest, Jodamba surely would have won it. But as you said, Jason, these are championship rounds. Uishi knows about those and pacing himself for them.
And you see Jodamba too, like he sets up his takedowns off of his strikes. He threw a couple of punches. The one thing I noticed though is that Jodamba is starting to let those hands go from his hips. He's punching from his waist a little bit. And even though he's connecting with more of those punches, when you sit in that pocket and you have that distance where you're gonna punch your opponent and your opponent can punch you, it's a trade-off. You know, that guy can just as easily catch you with one. So there is by no means a check mark in the column of Jodamba having won this fight yet. Uishi is very tough and at any point can turn the tables.
Uishi just took an elbow to the side of the head, not quite on that eye, but certainly around it. And Jodamba's work is busy and there's good quality in there. And he is running away with this fight. 8 minutes left. 8 minutes left in this contest. And Uishi needs to dominate those 8 minutes.
You know, they say styles make matchups. And if you look at the record of both of these men, they both have a common opponent in Hanario Benario. And even though Uishi knocked Hanario out twice, definitively put a mark on that in his career, and Jodamba beat Benario by decision, some people would look at that and say, oh, well, this is a fight that Oishi's going to win, but that doesn't necessarily translate to mixed martial arts because the styles and the different timing and how you feel out your opponent, it just changes everything from your game plan to how you ebb and flow in there. As you're seeing here, you know, Jodamba's been more dominant up through the first 17 and a half minutes or so.
Good cuffing left hand landed high from Jodamba, who's doing the classier work in the stand-up.
Even though Jidama's been flat-footed, he has just been stalking prey this whole fight moving forward. And Oishi's been in you know, a good stance and moving really well, but he hasn't been able to find his range.
Continues to cut off Oishi's circling with expert timing and movement. The Mongolian, and he's coming back with decent uppercuts, weren't they? A little bit of blood trickling from Jadamba's nose.
There's a head kick again.
Oh, he missed with an absolutely sweeping uppercut that could have taken his head off had it connected with the chin.
Boy, at this point, Koji's really just trying to, I think, avoid engaging. And that counterpunching hasn't really done as much damage as I think he'd like it to have. It's very difficult to win fights on your heels and to keep moving backwards. There's only a handful of guys that I think are superior counterpunchers. Usually you have to move forward and try to dictate the pace of the fight. And that may be the definitive factor.